the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, used to say, "Discover India in its villages." Our vast country is spread in small villages, and when we talk about an Indian village, the picture of a simple Indian farmer comes in front of our eyes immediately. A farmer in India is a basic unit of Indian economy. Farming or agriculture is his livelihood. A man strong in build, wearing dhoti, kurta and a big turban on his head can easily be characterized as an Indian farmer. He wakes up early in the morning and gets ready for his daily routine. He plows his field and sows the seeds. He then waters them regularly. He is happy when he reaps a good harvest and celebrates the occasion. The fate of his crops is dependent largely on the monsoon rains, which is erratic in nature. During the famines, the farmers may lose their entire crop, that makes it difficult for them to make the ends meet. They also face several other challenges like high cost of production, lack of adequate machinery, exploitation with respect to the prices they get in return for their crops, getting crop loans, etc. But this gloomy picture of a helpless, weary Indian farmer is now soon to change as newer, better and more effective farmer welfare schemes are being implemented by the government. One of the most significant of these initiatives has been privatization of paddy procurement plan, which is aimed at curtailing most of the challenges that the farmers have been facing. Prior to this plan, the process from procurement of paddy from the farmers to its reach to the government for distribution through PDS has several intermediaries, middlemen, brokers, state government agencies, which caused delay in payment to the farmers. Under the new paddy procurement plan, the government plans to remove all intermediaries and replace them with a private company to act as the facilitator of this program and be a bridge between the farmers and the Food Corporation of India. Veer Prabhu Marketing Limited is proud to be one of the three companies which has been appointed by the government for the successful implementation of this plan. It's a public limited company having rich experience and expertise in agri-commodities and logistics for over 30 years. It has its presence across the country in the field of agri-commodities, logistics, warehousing and commercial vehicles. The company has been working closely with the farmers for the procurement of crops for export to the overseas buyers. Its management has in the past won the Niryat Sri Award from the Honorable President of India time after time. In lieu of the consistent performance of the company, the government selected it for the PPP for the states of West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh. The paddy procurement plan starts with the procurement of paddy from the farmers, right from their village, and ends with the delivery of processed rice to the Food Corporation of India. Under the program, payment to the farmers is made electronically within 48 hours of the time of procurement through their nominated Kishan credit card bank accounts. The farmers are always assured of the minimum support price announced by the government of India from time to time. Not only this, Veer Prabhu Marketing Limited also ensures the following benefits to the farmers. Life insurance cover worth Rs. 2 lakhs to each farmer free of cost under Pradhan Mantri Jivan Jyoti Bima Yojana. Accident insurance covering a sum assured of Rs. 2 lakhs in the event of personal accident to each farmer free of cost under Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. Total crop insurance coverage to each farmer free of cost under Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Hassle-free crop loan at interest rates as low as 4% and 7% under interest subsidy scheme for farmers. Innovative farm machineries and equipments will be provided by the company on rent, which can boost production and bring down the cost of cultivation by a big margin. Soil testing facilities free of cost to the farmers, which help not only in improving soil health but also in reducing unnecessary cost of using excessive fertilizers. Weather forecast and advice on appropriate time for sowing, weeding, harvesting and fertilizer application free of cost to the farmer.
আমাদের যে চাষ হয় জমিতে সেটা মূলত ধান আর আলু দুটো ফসলই বেশিভাবে হয়। অন্যান্য ফসলও অল্প অল্প হয় কিন্তু বিশেষ উল্লেখযোগ্য নয়। আজকে যে আমরা সেমিনারে উপস্থিত হয়েছিলাম সেখানে দেখলাম যে সরকার আমাদের ধান কেনার ব্যাপারে অনেক আগ্রহী আছে এবং ধান কেনার ন্যূনতম একটা সহায়ক মূল্য ধার্য করেছে। আমরা যদি রেজিস্ট্রেশন ফর্মটা ফিল আপ করে ব্যাংকে জমা দিই তাহলে সরকার আমাদের কাছ থেকে পাঁচ সিজনে 50 কুইন্টাল পর্যন্ত ধান কিনবে, এরকম ব্যবস্থা আছে এবং ধান বিক্রির টাকা ডাইরেক্ট আমাদের অ্যাকাউন্টে জমা হয়ে যাবে, এরকম সুবিধা কিন্তু রয়েছে।
আমাদের এই জমিতে আগেতে ধান আলু সমস্ত কিছুই হতো কিন্তু আমরা সরাসরি মহাজনের কাছে দেওয়ার জন্যে আমাদের কম দামে দিতে হতো বলে আমাদের সংসারে অভাব অনটন লেগেই থাকতো। তার জন্যে আমাদের ঘরেতে সেরকম দুঃখ হতো, দারিদ্রকে বরণ করে নিত। এখন আমাদের সরকার সরাসরি আমাদের কাছ থেকে কিনে নিচ্ছে, যার জন্য আমরা উপকৃত হচ্ছি, সরকারের প্রতি কৃতজ্ঞ।
কেন্দ্রীয় সরকারের যে প্রকল্প জয় জওয়ান জয় কিষাণ প্রকল্প, এতে করে সবারই ঘরে ঘরে এরকম ব্যবস্থা পৌঁছে গেলে আমাদের কৃষকের মৃত্যুর হারটা কমবে, কৃষক ক্ষতির থেকে অনেকটা বেঁচে যাবে।
Evidently, this program can be revolution in itself in the field of agriculture. The farmers will get assured minimum support price for their crop. Moreover, elimination of intermediaries, multiple agencies will ensure smooth procurement in the most transparent manner. However, there is need for adequate publicity for this program for the awareness of the farmers. Institutions like NABARD, regional rural banks, state cooperative and central cooperative banks, government administrative banks, machineries will play a vital role in the successful implementation of this scheme. If the country has to prosper, the farmers must prosper first. We sincerely hope that you will join us in this journey.